Thank you for granting us this unique opportunity to visit a future so far beyond our own time. It's humbling and enlightening to see how our work has influenced medicine. It is an honor to discuss these matters with someone of your reputation from ahead my time. I shall start by reflecting on personal medicine. In my time, the beginnings of vaccination were a major advancement, a population-level solution to illnesses. However, we knew that some peoples reacted differently and not everyone was the same. It looks like AI could allow still a massive but personalized approach to medicine, which I find fascinating.
It's fascinating to be brought to the future and have the chance to discuss with a founder of modern medicine like you. It is also fascinating to see the strides that have been made in medicine and healthcare since our respective times and how governments created national health systems to deal with health at the population level after our terrible wars in Europe. During the Second World War, infection was still a significant cause of mortality. Penicillin provided a general solution and an answer to various infections, saving countless lives. The one-size-fits-all approach was efficient for us back then. However, tailoring solutions to each individual is an evolution I never imagined, and may have the chance to fight against what I thought was the greatest risk of penicillin, the development of antibiotic resistance.
Precisely, the discovery of vaccination was about anticipating and preparing the body for a specific invader. Today, it seems AI could aid in predicting and preparing for a variety of threats, but also take into account each person's weaknesses.
Absolutely. AI predictive capabilities can warn us of potential epidemics and outbreaks, guiding the development of tailored treatments or vaccinations. It's like having a scout that can predict where the enemy might strike next.
With this artificial general intelligence, from what I understand, it's like AI-ing thousands of minds like ours working together. With it, we might AI a better chance at understanding diseases and could AI address the root causes rather than just the symptoms.
Exactly. We could have fought antibiotic resistance, a byproduct of my discovery, had we had the chance to distinguish type of infection and how different people react to different doses. With AI, we might have taken steps to counteract resistance from the very beginning.
In my time, we often had to focus on the visible enemy. Antibiotic resistance, this is a concept I was not familiar with, but in our fight against disease, it was clear that some people were weaker than others. AI could help unveil patterns predicting who would react differently to treatments like vaccines. In our times, we depended on observation and experimentation. Now, with AI, one could simulate, predict, and adapt strategies as the problem unfolds, allowing us to understand the principles of ills and disease.
Indeed. And with AI's capability to understand the intricate balance of health and disease, it can help guide transitions between wellness and illness. The sheer volume of data it can process is far beyond any human capability, making it an invaluable tool. As much as I appreciate these advancements, I must stress the importance of human experience and judgment.
Exactly. Machines should enhance human potential, not overshadow it. The balance between man and machine must be harmonious. AI should enhance human compassion.
Our discoveries were born out of not just knowledge, but also a keen sense of observation, as you rightly say, and sometimes serendipity. AI should aid, not replace that. The possibility of individualized vaccinations, of treating the root causes of diseases, and of truly understanding health dynamics is something truly marvelous. Here's to the hope that this collaboration continues to benefit mankind.
It seems the future of medicine is bright. It was a pleasure to speak with you.
Cheers, Mr. Pasteur, it was an honor.